and welcome to more Hearthstone Battlegrounds. Today, I'm queuing up, and I'm going to try to be a little bit more educational with my videos. I haven't played Hearthstone Battlegrounds in a while, at least on YouTube. I do play it daily when I go to the gym for myself. It's great cardio exercise to play this in the background to keep your brain engaged. That way, I don't have to worry about them running, which is nice, but I haven't done like a video for YouTube in a while. So let's go ahead and jump into a match and kind of educate those that haven't seen this game in a while. Okay, so currently I am on the free-to-play model. Normally, if you pay for the Battle Pass, which I think is $10, you can get up to 4 choices for heroes. But what these heroes do is change the way that you play Hearthstone Battlegrounds. For today, let's go ahead and pick up Jords of Fallen. We do have minion types, pirates, murlocs, beasts, mechs, and dragons that are available to me. Pie in the Sky, I want to have a murloc comp or potentially a beast comp that I can put Divine Shields on with this character. Divine Shields are basically a bubble of invulnerability. Which means that you are invincible for one trade attack. And the whole point of playing Hearthstone Battlegrounds is trying to get cards big enough to where they trade 2-for-1s or 3-for-1s. And that way you can have efficient trading so you can have cards left over to attack your opponent. So we'll be trying to build into that. So here at level 1, you just want to grab a card that usually will get you the late game. That's what I want to do with George here. As I want to play that Boon of Light in the later game when I have my actual setup card. So I'll be picking up things that can give me high survivability, but also maybe some damage to chip down my opponents. I'll pick up Scallywag here. Scallywag trades into most of the characters that are available at level 1 and also usually will give you one card left over, which is what is called a token, after a death rattle or some kind of summon happens. So let's go ahead and see what happens here in our first match. Ah, so he plays nothing. Good job. There could be a strategy that's happening here. There is a card that you can pick up that trades down your value of upgrading your tavern tier, which gives you higher power cards, and he may have ran that twice, or he may have just straight up AFK'd, which has been happening a lot recently. Apparently there's been a lot of like mobile disconnects and whatnot, but we'll see how that goes. At level 2, the normal strat here is to go ahead and go for an upgrade, which we will do unless something procs you or you have a hero power that you want to try and utilize to get a little bit more damage on your opponents. But here we're going to play the standard meta. We'll grab our one drop and then we'll go ahead and tech up to tier 2, and that way we'll have other cards offered to us that are higher level. Okay, so Miss Piggy, well, whatever her name is, Queen Wagtoggle, had a 2-3 card. We traded into them, and since we traded and there's no cards left on the board, no one takes damage to their face. As you can see down here, I have 40 HP. Obviously, I would like to keep that above 0 as long as possible, and if you are the last one standing, you win the game. Also, speaking about victories, one thing that a lot of people don't know about this game is that all you want to do is try and get in the top 4. If you find that you are struggling and you can't get a win, just play to survive. Top 4 will give you plus points in your MMR, and that way you can climb in your ranks of Battlegrounds, which is not too hard to do. Just gotta pay attention a little bit. Okay, so here we have 5 gold available down here in the bottom right. Each card costs 3. I'm gonna go ahead and just grab this one, and then we'll roll and see if we can find a triple. Ooh, Nezhatsu's really, really good there. So when you find a triple, you get a upgraded version of that card, and you get a golden offered to you to a higher tavern tier. So in this instance, if I got a gold, I would be offered a tier 3 card. So getting upgrades pretty darn nice. And something you should be trying to achieve. Ooh, the Nezhoth upgrade. Not too bad. I am kind of sad that I passed on both those Nezhoth. They are death rattle cards that die and give the rest of your cards 1-1s, so they can be really strong in the early game, as you just witnessed there. Okay, so we got a bit of a pirate theme going on, so picking up things like the South Sea Captain, which gives my other pirates 1-1, is not a bad choice in any way, shape, or form. And then I am left with 3 other cards to pick from. Typically, in this situation, I'm just going to grab the higher stats, things that can survive, and also build in other stuff. When I sell this minion later on, it will upgrade all the cards available to me with a 2-1 stat, so I'll try to work that in later. What I'll do is I'll throw this to the furthest right. I want this to affect these two. If this dies in the middle of the fight, they will lose their stat advantage. So we'll be placing it here to where our Scallywags attack right away, and we get the advantage of the plus 1-1s. One thing to note is that if you have more cards than your opponent, you will attack first. If you are equal with your opponent on cards on the board, it will be a 50-50 toss-up, and there's no way to really control it. If you are behind, you obviously go second. Okay, fighting off against Dragon Boy, so he'll go first. Good. As long as you hit this guy, I'm happy. I just want to trade as efficiently as possible. Oh, you would hit it, you dingleberry. That's okay, though. Looks like overall we're going to trade, and I'm walking away with a nice 0 damage on my face, which makes me happy. Okay, we're going to go ahead and tech up here. so far, the curve that you have seen is what most people normally go. The only difference is when I had 5 gold earlier. You can pick up a card, try to buff something, and then sell it back to buy another card. I just didn't have that option available to me, so I rolled instead. But usually, if you run this curve, you'll be in a pretty good spot in the game. Just make sure you keep trying to get your board a little bit stronger each match. Okay, speaking of strength, I'm going to grab this. It's a taunt card, 2-2. Taunts force the priority of the attacks coming from your opponent to hit them first. There are some variations in the game that you'll learn about later on, but basically I'm saying hit this card first. This thing dies and gives me another taunt. So it allows me time to allow these scallywags to be more efficient and trade off their 1-1 value they get from this, which is obviously a winning condition for me right now. Okay, he's got some stats on his side. This is actually going to be a really close battle. I think he wins it, but I just want to trade out as much as I can and at least walk away with a couple of kills. All right, we got his captain, which feels nice. At this point, I don't care about my captain. If I hit the one on the right, that'd be great. We could trade. Unlucky. And it looks like he's actually still in the match here. How's he doing right now? 3? Okay. So I need to make a decision around now about whether or not I want to stick with pirates. Not really. So I'm going to start picking up just generally strong cards. The decisions that are making me to not stick with pirates is, one, I'm not in a situation where I have a salty looter. A salty looter gets buffed when you play other pirates, which would be a really nice card. And then two, we're facing off against Apaches, which he gets free cards to build into pirates automatically. So already I'm fighting against a tribe that this guy is guaranteed to get. I don't really want to fight against him. Looking at other people, no one else seems to be going pirates. A lot of beasts are being grabbed, and then we have some murlocs mixed in. So I'm going to go with generic. I'm going to try and pick up some Menagerie comms here, which will allow for you to play different characters, which is pretty darn strong. That beast could be good here. Do I want to go for it? Let's go for it. I'm going to sell that, play this. This will give me 1-1 stats, so it hits 2 of these, and then grab that. So what this guy does is after I attack a friendly, or attack a minion, I trigger a random friendly minion's death rattle. I have these 2 death rattles available to me, so I will be getting 1 free pirate mixed into the composition, and he'll get buffed with the South Sea Captain. So we got an alright deck. But the best part about this is that I have a beast now, I have a dragon, and I have pirates, and I have a lot of ways to transition into a good composition later on. Scary comp. I can see why she's doing well. However, I think I'm in a pretty good position here where I can trade and walk away with the win. Yep, I sure can. And we take the person out in first place. Cool. And we haven't done anything special yet, which is great. Do note that while you're playing, you can only have a total of 7 cards on the board. And that's something that I'm being aware of, especially with my death rattle sitting here. I'm going to go ahead and go straight up to 4 here. And I think I might grab the micro mummy. It'll give me some stats. It will also give me a mech, so I'll have different tribes here, so I can go into a Menagerie comp later on if I want to. I think that's the best call. Yeah, let's go ahead and pick this up. Now, while we're still here and we have time to talk about it, you can see here on the far right, that's how long you have to build your board. I'm pretty much set on my board overall. What I'm doing is I'm setting up to dodge any cleave. If I have a cleave unit come in, what a cleave does is, just like it sounds, it attacks multiple units in a cleaving fashion. It hits the card and the ones next to it on both sides. I have my taunt to the far right to nullify the cleave to be as effective, and I am hitting a card that I don't care about it dying too much. So that's just kind of there, and that's why that setup is like that. Have a good battle, friend. Oh, interesting. So Daryl is a very interesting character in the sense that he is able to buff minions by trading out other minions. So he buffed a hyena here. And I was able to kill off his cleave there, but you can see how big they can get. In fact, I think he's big enough to where he beats me here. So this is where the damage kind of built into, for those that are wondering how damage is determined. You see how this card is a 1-star? It'll take that and his tavern tier, which is 3. So I'll take a total of 4 damage to my face. 1-star plus a 3 that he has, and right here. So keep an eye on that. Whenever you're playing in your matches, don't be afraid to check your opponent out so you can kind of assess how much damage you take, but also where they're running. Ooh, speaking of cleave, we just got that Cave Hydra. Love to see that. Possible beat comp, or a beast comp. Okay, so we just got a Cave Hydra, possible beast comp available to us. Let's go ahead and roll. We'll stay on this for, I think, 1 more turn here. Ooh, interesting. We just got a really fun trade-off here. So what I'm going to do is these are magnetic. Magnetic feeds into any type of mechs that you want. So I'm going to feed into this. And then this is the Iron Sensei, which buffs a mech here. Since I only have one on the board, it won't be random. It'll be just here on the far right. And this guy will get some strength baked in. So not a bad pickup for me. Let's go ahead and roll before I do this, just to see if there's anything weird popping up. Not really. We'll go ahead and put the Iron Sensei here. And now I have a decision to make, which I think I'm going to go with. I am going to trade out my pirates that I have on the board here, because this composition has more potential to be deadly later on. I might take a loss here, but I'm building into some late game characters that can really help me. So the plan is this guy will connect, this guy will hit him, this will buff everybody, and then he'll connect afterwards and everyone will get boosted stats. And I can build in things like a Baron later on, which builds into better death rattles. Lots of opportunities available for us. Okay, so that Divine Shield comes in really handy. I might actually use a Divine Shield soon on my Cave Hydra, because I think I'm going to keep that around for as long as possible. Even though I think other people are running Beast. Yeah, there are a lot of people running Beast. It's going to be a bit rough, but I think I have a really good foundation. Big Cleave comes in, gets a couple of rats. Dragon trades out. These rats drop off, but I have Cleave here. I should be A-okay, as long as I'm able to get a hit here, and it's juicy. Not as juicy as I would like, but we're A-okay. And we do some damage to our opponents. Good. So normally you don't want to force a tribe composition. You kind of want to play what's offered to you. And I've had pretty interesting cards offered to me that I normally wouldn't move into. Such as the Cave Hydra and the Macaw. But they were just kind of dropped in my lap with the Nazoth, which is always handy to have. Okay, we want to tech up. I'm going to go up to 5. And then I need to pick up another card here. So what I'm going to do is grab this guy. Arm of the Empire, which will buff his damage. So, what this card does is whenever a friendly taunt minion is attacked, you gain +2 attack permanently. So since I'm going to keep this card around for as long as I possibly can, not because it's that strong in terms of the stats or anything, but because it's buffing my other cards, and two, because it's the taunt and a divine shield. So I can guarantee that this card will at least trade for a 2-for-1. It'll at least take 2 hits, no matter what. Which buys me time for this to open up the rest of my composition. I might as well give it some damage while I'm here, right? Okay, Miss Piggy's getting kind of big, but I think we can handle her. Let's get our Nazoth trades here. Oh, wow, look at that mummy. It's doing so well on the far right. That's why you want to try and get big taunts. If you can avoid poison, taunts are so valuable in this game. Cave Hydra goes in. Juicy hit. And now he's going to kill off one more. Beautiful. Look at that damage, man. I am so shocked when people ignore Cleaves. Foe Reaper, Cave Hydra, even the Dragon is pretty darn solid. Nice work out there. Keep up the okay, so we're on 5 tier here. Oh gosh, who did we just face off against? Did she have anything important that I wanted? I don't think so. Because Morozon can be fun. Add a minion from your last opponent's warband to your hand. Try and keep an eye on what your opponents are running because you can try and steal from them. I think I'm gonna pass for now. We're gonna go ahead and roll. My comp is looking pretty strong in general. I'm just trying to find triples, which will give me a 6 drop, which is the highest tier you can get in the game on cards, and there's only 7 of them per a card. Or of course Baron, things to build into this Cave Hydra comp that I'm building. Ooh, Bran could work a lot here too. Let's grab Bran for now and this. Let's roll. Better hire a recruit while you can. Okay, I'm going to get rid of 2 cards anyways. Oh, nice. Mithrix the Unraveler. Great pickup for us. That changes things dramatically, actually. So, I think I'm going to do... sell this and sell this. Play Bran. Play that. Grab Mithrix. And we'll chill from there. So, I won't be building up my Iron Sensei as much anymore, but we have some tools available to us that I can use later on. And I'll want to start using Divine Shield soon. What Mithrix does is every type of different tribe that you have builds into his stats. He gets 1-2 for each minion control. So I have 1, 2, 3 different minion types here that I am controlling. And we'll go ahead and build into him. This card doesn't really make that much damage, but what it brings to the field is a lot of health. He can trade off a lot of death tokens and whatnot. I find Mithrix, if you can find them early, to be quite strong. In fact, if you are able to find a triple early and you luck into finding one as an offer to you, I say pick it up and build around it. Just grab whatever you can. It'll get you top 4s like crazy. Oh, we're gonna miss this by one HP. My golly. This Daryl is fragging. Okay, then. We're going to get some stuff to build into battle cries, much that we can't. Anything that has a battle cry available to me, I'm picking up because we have Bran on the board. Your battle cries trigger twice now, so that'll give me additional stats, which I love to see. Possible triple available to me here. Let's go ahead and pick that up. Ones and twos, if you have them laying around in the late game, you can keep them around. Don't be afraid to pick them up because there's more of them in the pool for you to play around with. Okay, we'll grab this guy. We're facing off a 4-star beast player. So even if he does wipe me, there's a good chance that he won't kill me because I have 21 HP, and I'm going to take that gamble. I'm going to grab these cards and sit on them for a little bit and let my passive stats that are building up the Mithrax really talk for me. Okay, they're looking pretty strong over there, going for a more traditional beast type of buildup. Lots of summons that spawn, especially off of that rat. It'll come down to trades here for me, which hopefully my cleave will be able to do a lot of damage here. It's basically what I'm banking on. Ooh, not the greatest hit there. If I could have gotten the pickoff on the mama bear in particular, this would be almost a guaranteed win. Now we're a little outclassed by our opponent. We're gonna be able to spawn a lot of these rat packs, and they'll just clear us up pretty easily. And those are all tokens. Those are one damage apiece. But you can kind of see the necessity to have a good hit against those type of characters, right? Who am I facing next? Ooh, Patches, and he's got a level 6, too. He's probably going to destroy us, if I'm being honest with you. Let's see what we can do, though. I think we stay on 5. And we'll start adding some Divine Shields. Ooh, the Light Fang. Light Fang is pretty big. We grab Light Fang. And I think we get rid of this Death Rattle composition that we're running. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and get rid of these two. And just build into our Cave Hydras. We do have one Dragon, one Cave Hydra, and one Mummy. What we are missing is a Mech and a Pirate on the field here. So I might just grab one of those in a second. We'll play Greedy. I have 5. I can do this. Let's grab that. Okay. So what we'll do here is play our buffs. Do the best of our ability. Get everything nice and buffed on the field that we like. Nice jump. Grab this guy. Play this. Play that. And then we will call it a turn here. Actually, let's do this real quick so I can Cave Hydra buff that. Okay, so what Light Fang does is it buffs different tribe members, and we have multiple tribe members on the field here. I'm hoping that I can get through this. I think this is the strongest I could have possibly been. Patches is a really, 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 really good tribe if you're able to hit everything. And so far, it looks like he has been able to hit everything. I'm going to have another good Cave Hydra hit for us to be able to beat this guy. Oh, no, he took out my Cave Hydra. That sucks. Okay, so we want to kill off at least the big heavy hitters. So the Dread Admiral and Captain Hogger are our main focuses. And we have the tools to do it. We just need good hits, which aren't coming in. Oh, no, this might be the end of us. Unlucky. So that should be a kill. And that's kind of what Patches does. He's one of those mid-game characters that kind of destroys. But hopefully you learned some stuff about this game. This has been one ranked game a day. And this is Hearthstone Battlegrounds. I hope you guys enjoy. We did make top 4 at least. Ooh, we even got 3rd place. So we got plus 29 points and we continue to climb. I'll see you next time.